Hello friends, my name is Mukesh Badgujar and now we will see some other settings and some other functions in the Adobe Flash CS3. So if you have to change this layout, if you don't have this property panel, or if you don't have this color panel, or if you don't have this, so at that time what we can do, at the time if you don't know, so that time you have to uninstall this setup and again reinstall that setup, and then you get all that thing. So if you know how to import that time you can easily do it. So click on window and go to the workspace and click on default. So this is your default workspace. So if I click on other, so here is the I icon and text. So I click as that, it is shown as this. So as this we can see, so there is the many workspaces. I choose default, it is better. So if I don't have only property panel, then I choose the properties and property panel. So here I see the property panel. Here is the many panels like library, and see this is the library panel and other things are here. So by this way you can see your workspace settings, or if you want to your default, if you want to make your own workspace, that time you have to manage that. Click on manage and manage workspace and click OK, and that time means by these settings you can do the your own workspace. Means you have to set up this all this thing where you want to put and what all other things. Means see, here's property panel, also parameters also is there. Then in tools we select main and we select other things, controllables, other is not. Then we see the actions. So we have how to save this this window. To save, go to workspace and save current. So as this we can name it at time pass. So I click OK and then window, go to the workspace and see here your your saved workspace here. If you want to default, then you go there, and if you wanted to change previous, then you go to the workspace and time pass. So as this way you can use your workspace settings. So I choose my default. I love default setting and I don't want this. So I toolbar, main, edit bar. No, I want edit bar. I want edit bar. But I don't want this. So is the workspace setting. Next we use the color panel. So what is the color panel? So we see the color panel and how to use colors. We know how to use color, but color panel settings, we in the right side you see the color panel. If you don't see, then go to windows and see the color panel. This is the color. So next click on here. If you see the many colors, this same option is appear on here. This and this both are the same, there is no difference. If you click on this, and this eyedropper tool will be appear. So we select any color which we want like this. So we can choose any color from here also and from where also. So here is some types, that is the solid, linear, radial, bitmap. So we use some of them. So first we have to draw a square or anything and click on that. We select color, we select a color and fill by the ink, fill by the paint bucket tool. See carefully, it is the ink bottle tool that will be select color from here. So paint color, color as I told you, paint color, paint bucket tool used to fill color, and ink bottle tool to paint the border of the color like this. So next is the, this is the black and white or exchanging, and this is the exchanging color. This is the none of color, konsa bhi color nahi, and this is the black and white. So this is the preset shortcuts for that. So next, here we can also changing our custom color, what color, what the shade we want and how we can apply that color. So here is also some sliders, you can choose your custom color, what color you have to want and other thing. So here is the alpha also. See, here is the alpha. That alpha is used to lightening and brightness of your color. So I select this. So this color is so light and I paint this. If I choose alpha on the 100%, then I paint it. So see the difference between alpha on low and alpha on high. So this is used for alpha, and this is the color name. And then if we want to linear color, so in the linear color there are, see here, some extra panel. In solid drawing it is not panel, but in linear color we see some extra panel. If I select this color and here, sorry, if I select here this color and now I choose the linear. Okay, linear may linear will not select. Why linear not select? Okay, it's okay. So I select from color here. I simply double click on that and I select this color. And here also I click double click and I select what color I want. So if I fill that color, so see, so what color I filled? See here, this is somewhat of blue shade in this. Means here is the overflow option that I will show you the difference for that. See, there is the little bit difference on this color and this color. So if you can't see the difference, so I will change the color. If I want to add more, so then simply click on that, it will add other. Means, so I fill that color, linear, selected linear, but it here is the not appearing the linear color. So why this color is not appearing here? I can't understand that. I found that here, if I choose linear, then here is the somewhat of different colors that will be available on here. We choose it on here also. If I choose linear, then I add some few colors like this. I double click on that and I use some colors, and this also for this I use this. So I am making that this color. So I want to fill this color on the box. So I use, if I click on this, so this color will not fill. So I use this, click on that, and here you see this color. So click on this, click on this, you have to add this on your panel. So simply you have to select linear and click on the rectangle tool and draw. See, here you will able to see the color like this. We have made that color. If you don't believe that, so this, see this color we have made. So we can use all of this color by using this. If you want presets, then we use that also. See how we will use. If you want to add your custom presets to here, you can also able to add that. I will tell you. So to adding your custom color, first simply select linear, and if you want some other color, so I don't want this, so change color whatever you want. So I want this color and this color and this color also. It is changed to this color. So as this way I want some many colors in my this. So I want to save this color to here, but I cannot save. But to save this, so click on here, see the lines, so click on that and add to swatches. Click on add to swatches, you will have able to see your color here. See, your color is here. See, you can add many more colors whatever you want. If I remove that, click here, new color, double click. I want this. So I want to save this color. So I want to save click this color and click to add swatch, and you will see here all that colors too. So we use the linear color like this. So same as radial color, we use the radial color also by that. Sorry, what is this? This is the big mistake will made by me. Where is the, this is this. So by this way we can use the linear color and other colors. Bitmap, so bitmap color we want to click on that and we draw that color, means we use the image as the color also. So by this way we can draw. So none means the no color to draw. No color to draw means see empty box. See, this is empty box. So by this way we can draw all of these things. So this is the some settings of workspace and some colors and some settings other. So in next video we will see other something more good than this, and other things and many more things we see. So thank you for watching this video, and subscribe to my channel.